Hello and welcome back, everyone, to Alternative Reality. Today, I have a very special guest and friend of mine, Andrew Mulichuk. Andrew, thank you for coming on to the show.
I'm glad you had me.
I absolutely am in love with Andrew's photography. I think it's incredibly talented and it's very inspiring. Andrew, you have one theme for these three photos that I'm going to present to people. What is your theme exactly?
Well, the title of the project was The Dichotomy of Public and Private Space. Basically, what I was trying to go for was doing things that people normally do in private in spaces where you would never commonly find them, public spaces, things of that nature. So I figured out different situations, scenarios, and then we went there, did it, and took a picture.
First photo that we have, which is just fantastic. I believe it's a photo of you brushing your teeth underneath a car.
That is correct. Like I said, private thing. Usually everyone brushes their teeth in the bathroom. It's not something that, you know, anyone else can see. So I decided to, you know, do it in a tight, closed space under a truck. And when I was looking for the, you know, the right vehicle, this truck stood out. It was like really rusty and like, you know, old and raw looking. So I was like, whatever, I'll choose that.
So was it uncomfortable down there?
it was tough. It was tough sliding under there. I got a couple brush burns, but it's
how
all
long
good.
Were you under there for?
Too long.
So is there a title for the piece?
Yeah, like as I mentioned before, the title of the whole project, each piece doesn't have its title. Like, I mean, you could call that Teeth versus Truck if you want, but mainly I was just looking at the whole thing as a whole, and it's the dichotomy of public and private space.
That's pretty hilarious. You know, the one thing that really stands out to me is the color of the toothpaste down there and the toothbrush, which is orange.
Yeah.
They're both complementary colors, right?
I didn't really have that in mind, but I wanted to pick something like the toothbrush and toothpaste that you'd be able to see, you know, in contrast with the pavement of the parking lot as well as the truck. So the blue and the orange really, you know, make it visible so people can know what's going on.
Oh, that was a really good artistic choice. So our other photo that we have is with you, I believe, in the supermarket, cleaning your ears. Is that a bag of groceries too? What's in the bag?
I honestly don't remember. I think actually my partner, Ben Nix, I'll give a quick shout out to him, whatever he's doing. Hopefully he's alive and well. But he like wanted to buy something so it'd make more sense because I didn't want to just go through the line with nothing. And he's actually the one taking all these pictures that you see. I'm in all of them. But anyways, like I said before, like cleaning your ears is something you do in private. It's something, you know, other people usually don't see you do. You don't want them to see you do it. So I decided to, you know, go through the checkout, and as I was paying the lady, start cleaning my ears. And it was really funny,
Did she have any idea what you were doing?
She had no idea because I had my partner sneak around, so she had no idea the back of her head is even on film. And, like, it was funny because she was working, so she probably wanted to say something to me, but she couldn't just because, like, you know, she's in her
job mode. Trying to be polite.
Oh, I don't know about that. Like, at first, like, her eyebrows were raised. She, like, had a look of shock on her face. And then it sort of turned into, like, a little bit of a frown. Like, she was, like, disgusted with what I was doing. I was loving it. It was fun.
Wow. You have a real sense of humor that shines through your pieces. And I really love this one. It's very non-traditional. I think that's what makes these photographs really special. And for our last photo that you did, Andrew, this is a great one too. The color is just fantastic in the contrast. I noticed there's beer in this one.
Of course. Everyone loves beer.
So what is the idea behind this one?
All right, this one, once again, shaving. You know, most people just do it in the privacy of their own bathroom. So I wanted to do it in a public place. I went to Walmart. I went into the beer aisle.
Walmart.
Saw my reflection. I actually didn't pay for that shaving cream, so I had to, you know, get in and out relatively quickly. So who knows?
Right.
But yeah, it was really fun. I just wish like we took a few more pictures right there, actually. I wish someone was just walking by and just, you know, turned casually to look into the aisle and just saw what was happening, because that facial expression would have been priceless and definitely worth looking at.
What brand of shaving cream, might I ask?
It's been a while ago. Like, this wasn't a recent project. I did this last spring, so I honestly don't remember.
This is just an incredible piece. I love your artwork, Andrew. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Those were only three of the pictures that I had with me. There was a couple more. Like, for one, like, I simulated having sex on top of the front step of a church. That was pretty cool, too. Someone from inside the church actually came around, and he looked pretty pissed, so We got out of there quickly because he ran back inside. I can only assume like he was calling the cops or calling someone. So that was a good one. And there's just a couple other ones. Like, I just want to do things that people aren't used to seeing. Like, everyone gets so caught up in, you know, routine and everything's automated. I like, you know, when something unusual happens just to see how people react to it.
I think that's an incredible thing to capture and almost transcend time through photography, right? Because you're like capturing a moment, really.
Yeah, a pure moment, because everyone is, you know, basically can have a poker face, a neutral face, but when you come across something like, you know, some of my pictures, you get a pure, you know, pure reaction in the purest form.
That's incredible. I can't thank you enough for coming on and sharing your work. I hope you start putting your stuff online, maybe on Facebook.
It actually is on Facebook, so if anyone wants to look it up, it's Andrew, my last name spelled M-U-L-I-C-H-A-K. Just friend me and you can look at all the pictures.
Great. Thank you so much for coming.